Wednesday the 6th of June. It's day 9? Day 9. And we've come to Animal Kingdom. It's actually about 12:30 now. We had a bit of a lay-in this morning. In fact, exhausted yesterday. So I thought, you know what, let's all have a lay-in. Get up, wash my hair. I want to wear my hair down today. But I'm not sure how long it's going to last in the heat, because my hair and heat does not mix. Especially if it rains, because it'll be even worse. But it's cloudier today. Sorry, it's going to get wet. Put my hair out when we get wet though. Our first fast pass is Cali River Rapids. So might head over to there first. Might see what the queue's like for like a passage, because we haven't done it yet and we really want to do it. We might have to queue for like 2 hours. If that's the case, then that's what we'll have to do. Yeah, ready for a good day. Doesn't close till 10:30 tonight, so we've got a while. Free bag check. Animal Kingdom time! Second favourite park. Magic Kingdom's favourite park.
No.
My favourite park. What's your favourite park?
Universal.
Universal. And then Animal Kingdom.
So long.
Think they talk?
No.
No.
Oh,
Lion King.
Jungle, everybody. Lion King. Loud intercom. Anyways, welcome to the Wildlife Express. At this time, I ask that you please remain seated, keeping hands, arms, legs, feet, heads, tentacles, antennas, anything else you can think of inside the train at all times, with your backs firmly pressed against the benches. We thank you for respecting our no smoking policy here at the station. And on the trains is also if you're traveling with small children, make sure that they are either seated on your lap or beside you.
That's a tattoo. Have we got some stick tattoos?
Little
cast member.
Thank you.
Great flexible. We've got four. You've already stolen my one.
And away we go. Everybody, wave bye to those who make this train to my good friend Alice. And I can't see who's out there. So anyways, wave bye bye.
Like we're walking through the jungle.
The result is that
the ginger ninja. This one, a ginger tamarind.
Lion tamarins, wild population fewer than 3,200. So with cotton tops, we highlight a program called Proyecto TT. Education about the cotton top, as well as doing field studies to better understand.
Oh, there's another one down there, look.
Now with the golden lion tamarins.
Go in here.
What are you yabbering on about?
Where are we going?
In here. That's okay, I'm just recording.
Okay.
Got a picture?
Yes.
Yeah.
Get in there as well.
Wait. Yep, my mermaid is.
I got Valentine.
Go on, Daddy, put your arm right in. Keep going. Keep going.
Let me do it. Daddy, let me do it.
Who's that being there?
I'm not going close to that.
What if there's an actual chance doing that?
Put your hand in and find out.
No!
Look how scared you are. You big wuss. Orb spider.
I'm gonna go on this side.
It's not, we can't touch anything.
So I'm set.
What are you seeing then here? Oh, hello.
Lizzie. Hey, Lizzie.
What?
Hey, Lizzie the lizard.
Burping. Me burping.
Talking to you.
What's your name?
They're going, hey, you. Huh? Come on behind us. He's just staring at the water. He's staring at his reflection in the water. He's literally just staring at the water. They're playing musical statues, aren't they? So someone turn the music back on, that's what they're saying.
To drink.
Oh, this one's moving.
Hey, it's alive.
It's alive. This one here.
I'm not.
The one poking his bum at you.
Not.
Here he is.
He's looking at you.
Yeah, he's pointing at me. Maybe I should move.
Why are we going up sideways?
Oh,
We did?
Oh dear.
Yes, I should explain. I got this problem with my brain. Things get really scrambled in my head. I have short-term memory. I forget things almost instantly. I'm not even sure what I just said.
May I help you?
Oh.
Well, hi.
Name's Bruce.
Well, I'm Dory.
No, you don't need to know. I'm nobody really. I was just.
I'd like to invite you morsels to a little party I'm having.
Hey, look, balloons! It is a party!
Fish are friends.
Fish are friends.
Fish are friends. Not food.
From the ocean too. Sorry if I ever took a snap at your land.
What did you think of Everest? Everest? What did you think of Nemo?
Everest is good.
It's Jake. He's getting Everest. Everest.
Nemo was very good.
Did you like that?
Yeah, that was good. It's a bit different that you can see the people.
Yeah. I don't know why they do it when you can see the people.
But you get used to it.
Yeah.
It could be like because they want everyone to see like how they do it.
I never really wanted to watch a Nemo show before, but I thought we'll give it a go. I felt quite emotional. I cry anything, so it doesn't really matter. But
I think
it's
really that way.
Go and see.
Saying Everest is so close.
Everest isn't far. It's fast time.
Yeah.
The fast time for your favourite ride. Jake's favourite ride, Everest. He's been waiting all day, and now it's time to go ride. I don't know.
Because now they're already good.
I know.
And I can't trade that one because it's all year.
It is.
And that's like when you would buy.
Yeah.
Since 2018, so I'm not trading that one. And I do not want to trade Stitch because it was a mystery and I got him.
It looks so fun.
Exhibition Everest time!
Thank you.
She likes that bottle.
He's hiding.
Hey, Daddy, she got her butt out. Just like you did at Volcano Bay yesterday. Lunar!
What do they say? Yeah, why didn't they just go through?
That's a big bat, isn't it?
Why is it over there as well? Oh yeah,
look at that one.
That was all like kind of that.
That one's asleep.
Why did they put a barrier?
So they can fly around. You're in their home.
They can't fly in here.
Yeah, they want to.
No, but look, they've got their own little room over there.
Branch is like right in the way.
Oh,
they've grown a lot though, haven't they?
I thought that one in the middle was just about to fall off.
Yeah,
I
just fell off.
I think that's Mummy Tiger in the middle.
Might be. Is it? She nearly just rolled down the hill. I tried to jump down there. At the tiger.
Oh, look, she's cleaning her baby.
You're going to clean yourself.
What do you think? Did Mummy warn you which baby's male, which baby's Jake?
The one being cleaned is Jake. Yeah, one is you. Independent.
Where's the daddy tiger?
I don't know.
Maybe the daddy tiger's making dinner for him.
Yeah, making tiger dinner.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, they do.
What do they have for dinner?
You.
Uh-oh. I better run then before he realises I'm not in the kitchen. Everyone's getting jealous.
Okay, so we just saw the tigers.
Indeed. The little baby ones. And they're not that small anymore.
No. They're probably like a teenager.
About 10 months old.
They're so cute.
This is the sign how we knew they were going to find tigers. We haven't seen. It's just a house. They drove in a house. Maybe that's where the bats were. Look at that, there's a tiger one. It's a tiger.
Jake loves walking through an aviary. Why? Because birds love to land on Jake's head. Let's see if we can get one who wants to land.
On my head!
They don't like your head, they like Jake's head.
They like my
head. There's one up there. Come on, birdie. Here he is. Here's Jake's head. What are you eating?
Nothing.
What are you chewing?
Nothing.
What are you chewing?
What's that,
babe?
What?
What are you chewing? It's in there.
It is one of 5,000.
Rhino.
Now the reason those numbers are so low is because humans have been hunting them for their horns. This is illegal. It's known as poaching. And those horns are actually made of the same material as our fingernails and our hair. It's called keratin. So for that reason, scientists have still yet to find a scientific purpose for humans to have access to those horns. So we call a group of giraffes. It's one of the easier group names to remember because they are so very tall. It will reach heights of 18 to 20 feet tall. Even a newborn giraffe is born about 6 feet tall, so it's actually likely that a newborn giraffe is still taller than most of the people in the truck right now. Now, they only sleep for about 30 minutes a day. They will do so either standing up or sitting down, but you will almost never see a giraffe lie completely down and rest that neck on the ground. So that would put them in their most vulnerable position. Scout the savannah for their prey. Now, lions in particular, they are inactive 18 to 20 hours of the day. But those 4 to 6 hours that they do tend to be active tend to be at night. That's because it is cooler at night, as well as because during the day their eyesight's about the same as humans. But at night, their night vision is 6 times better than a human's night vision. So why not be more active when you can see a little bit better? That just makes sense. Down there on the right, those furry brown animals, those are water buck. Their skin will emit a smelly, greasy substance that pretty much waterproofs that coat of theirs.
The other one behind them.
Getting away.
Yeah, she's the alarm clock. Time for everybody else to wake up. Now, a lion's roar can be heard for up to 5.6 miles away.
Boys lick him.
Doesn't sound like it can, but it definitely carries.
We are queuing for a flight of passage. We couldn't get a fast pass, and the queue is an hour. No, it's not, it's 130 minutes. So yeah, this is really funky. Hopefully it's a lie. I hope it actually we get in for 15 minutes, which would be great, but I don't think that's going to happen very well.
It won't.
Here they are. Oh, it's gone all blurry. Yeah, we know you're there. He looks really light on here. It's actually quite dark. The sky looks light. You're looking forward to the queue line?
Yes.
Suck it up, because it's a good ride.
I just said yes.
Good.
Avatars were really tall, and they're like 9 foot.
An hour and 25 minutes.
Look!
He's sleeping.
Avatars are 10 foot.
Half 10 it closes.
Stop! There's a gate you have to get through. Say secret password. Say secret password.
Bum bum.
No.
Bum bum.
No.
Chewing bum bum.
No.
Bum bum.
No.
Bum bum.
No.
Have fun.
No.
Abigail, where is Melly?
No.
Abigail, like a digger. Rare.
No.
Chance to undertake an amazing Navi rite of passage, flying on the back of this powerful animal called an Ikron, or as we call it, a Banshee. The way you're gonna do this is by being matched to something called an avatar, and I'm here to help you guys get ready. But first, we have to scan you for Pandoran microparasites. All right, everyone, stay on your number and move your arms a bit. Okay, start scan. Start scan. You've all got them. But don't worry, they're very common around these parts. Let's start the decon.
Initiating GMR decon.
Stay still over your number, you're not going to feel a thing.
So we're worth giving for. Yeah. Hour and 45 minutes in the end. But it's amazing. I probably would go for it again when we come back. I can't get a fast pass. Because it's a brilliant ride.
That was a really long queue, but it was a really good ride.
Yeah. We knew it was good though, which is why we didn't mind doing it.
That was the last ride.
Flight of Passage. Number one ride.
Number
ever.
One?
Anywhere.
Everest.
Better than Everest. Better than Forbidden Journey, which I love. Best ride ever.